Good morning to one and all present here. Myself and Kalpna. I am from Sri G.K.Jain Higher Secondary School, Royapuram. Today, for the 10th standard, I am going to explain the lesson is nerve system. In last video, we saw about the neuron. Neuron is a structural and functional unit of nerve systems. The structure of neuron, dendrite, axon, cyton, etc., etc., we saw about that. Now, we have to see the nerve impulse. Impulse means a force, okay. So nerve's impulse means through the neuron, some force it has been exited together and it has been, how it has been transmitted. First thing, from the sensory organ, like eyes, ears, okay, from the sensory organ, from the environment, the sensory organ receive the some kind of noise or some kind of thing it has been received it. Then it has been sent it to the neuron at the dendrite, because dendrite is present at the surface of the neuron, so it has been received by the dendrite. Then again through the dendrite it has been sent, passed over into the cyton, then axon, again at the end of the terminal end, okay. So here the formation, here the transmission will be formed automatically, the impulsive will be happen in it, okay. At the end of the terminal end, again what happened, the neurotransmitter will be formed at the terminal end. The neurotransmitter will be formed at the end. It has been yield some chemical. Those chemical will be called it as a neurotransmitter. The chemical will be as a acetylcholine. Okay, that is the chemical which has been it. As soon as it has been secreted, again it has been sent it to the other, another end of the dendrites, because all the neurons it has been connected one to another. This is the formation. This is the way the passaging of messages from the dendrites to other, the like a brain, spinal cord, it has been sent it to like this, okay. So the neuron will be as a connecting from the dendrite, it has been ended with the terminal end, again the terminal end, the another dendrites will be connected with that. This is the way here it has been passed. Next we have to see the human brain. It is a control center of our body. It has been very controlled in its activities. The human brain, it is composed of three layers. First one is a durometer. At the base of the brain it is formed, it is the thickest one. And next one is the arachnoid membrane. It is present in between the middle layer. And last one is the pia meter, very soft in its nature. In this pia meter it has been connected with a lot of blood vessels. These are the three layers having, these three are the covering of your brains, okay. Let's see the brain. The brain have been classified into three, forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. So here it is a forebrain, the frontal lobe, and hindbrain, it is present between the forebrain and the hindbrain. Midbrain is present between the forebrain and the hindbrain. Hindbrain at the terminal end, okay. Let's see the forebrain. So forebrain will be having, it is made up of cerebrum and dorsal side of thalamus. It is a center side, it is a thalamus, and the ventral side it is a hypothalamus. So the dorsal as well as the ventral side is nothing else. It should be, if it is an outer covering, it should be a dorsal. The inner covering will be a ventral side. So the dorsal will be a thalamus and the ventral will be a hypothalamus. And next we see the cerebrum. So it is a cerebrum, okay. Cerebrum, it is divided into a, it is divided into a right as well as the left hemisphere. The cerebrum has been able to divide itself. If it is divided, means it should be having a right as well as the left hemisphere. And next one, it is not fully split up. It has been connected with the nerve fibers. So the nerve fiber will be called as a corpus callosum. If the brain have been divided, means it should be having in between that some of the nerve fiber have been there. Those will be called as corpus callosum. And next one, the outer side, that will be called it as a outer portion, will be a cerebral cortex. And that will be outer portion will be a gray portion, gray matter it will be otherwise called it as a, the outer portion gray matter will be a cerebral cortex, and the inner portion white matter will be a medulla. And next one, it should be, the brain, it should be like a surface. It should be having a upper as well as the lower side. It is like a waves, Okay, so if it is of the upper side will be a gyri, it will be called, and the depression lower side will be a sulci. Okay, and the cerebrum, which is for the intelligence, it is used for the intelligence, memory power, recalling, reminding those things. The cerebral part which will be helpful for the intelligent purpose of. Okay, and next one is the thalamus. Here it is a sensory motor signaling. If you have signaling like sensory, it should be like a sensory one, receiving the motor signaling like a taking, throwing like that. Okay, and next one, hypothalamus. It is the involuntary muscles. So voluntary muscles means we have to induce something, then only we will be called it as a voluntary. Involuntary means without any external thing, it has been happened by itself, like sweating, sleeping, hungry, anger, etc., etc. It will be called it as an involuntary muscle. So those hypothalamus will be the control center for the involuntary muscle, as well as the, it is able to control the temperature of our body, because always we have to maintain the temperature of your body. Okay, so it will be, hypothalamus play the vital role. And next one, this is the forebrain. And next one, midbrain. In the midbrain, it present between the forebrain, thalamus, as well as the inbrain. It will be called it as a midbrain. So always it will be present in the midbrain. Okay, so it will be called it as a, it is made up of the midbrain, it made up of corpora quadrigemina. The midbrain, which is made up of a substance called corpora quadrigemina, it is able to control the visual and auditory functions. So the midbrain will be able the functions of visual and auditory function. And next one, the hindbrain. Here is the hindbrain. It is having the pons, and it has been connected with the spinal cord, cerebellum, as well as the medulla oblongata. It will be there. So in the hindbrain, main importance of medulla oblongata will be there, as well as it has been connected with the pons, like it has been connected with the spinal cord. Okay, and next, most of the brain, it is covered with the 60% of fatty substance only. And next one, EEG, which is a device called electroencephalogram, that will be shortly called as EEG, which is a device used to detect some other injuries or like tumor in the brain. We have to detect by using the brain. So in this nerve system, we have detailedly discussed about the neuron. Structure of neuron is a very important question. And next one, structure of brain. Thank you.